Good morning, my mimic army. I am the AMDM Lee, and this is my cup of coffee. Which I'm out of. So what I'm doing here is actually giving you kind of a little update about what we do here. What we have on our Discord server, as well as what we do here on Twitch. First off, on Monday nights, we have our Q&A. This is set up at 9 p.m. Eastern, where we take questions both on here on Twitch, as well as live stream it on TikTok, and with our Discord patron support, asking questions about either about my homebrew world, about D&D in general, or we just BS about nerdy stuff. That's all it is. No requirements, nothing else, just somebody talking and having a good time for an hour or two. After that, we come across to our Black Door game, where a group of assassins have set out into the world. Now, what's unique about this game is almost all of the classes that are being played are homebrew subclasses or completely new homebrew classes. They were made by our one of our mods and on our Discord server. And this is kind of it's really a playtest game. It's been a lot of fun. They've come across a few little adventures trying to figure out what they're going to do in the world. Come check it out. Like I said, it's a lot of fun. Next up, we have on Wednesdays and Thursdays are usually my days of rest for when I try to play games. Now, Thursday will be changing soon. I have to get some scheduling issues corrected out, but we will be starting a new campaign soon, strictly for certain Patreon members. Now, this will not be a bunch of one-shots like our Friday night game. It will be a full-blown campaign delving into some of the deeper lore on my homebrew world. But then that brings us to Friday. Friday is some of the funnest games I've ever played. There are a series of one-shots for our Order of the Scale. Now, this game is 100% first-come, first-served to our Patreon supporters. It goes every Friday night from 8 p.m. to usually around 11. And I never know exactly who's playing, what they're playing, what class they are, what level they are. But it's a lot of fun. It's a lot of fun for me, anyway. But I just wanted to cover these things with you. I wanted to let you know what we do, why we're here. And I wanted to and also take this moment to say thank you. Thank you for your support. Thank you for watching. If you would like to support and you haven't yet, there are multiple ways to do so. One of which is using your Amazon Prime Twitch account. If you've got Amazon Prime, and you're not using your free Twitch subscription, I'd be more than happy to use it. Another way you can support us is with our come join us on Patreon. That gives you access to a lot more stuff. Believe me, there's a lot more stuff. You also get early access to any homebrews we create, all kinds of goodies on there. But if that's not quite your cup of tea and you're wanting to get a little bit more out of it, you can come check out our Zazzle site, where you can get cool things like this bandana. This is a battle map bandana. It's set out in grid work, and there are other maps that I've been designing and getting ready to publish out on there. We have t-shirts. You can get yourself an AMDM t-shirt. You can get yourself a Mimic. There's some Mimic Army stuff coming soon. So, yeah, if you want to support us, but you don't want to do the Patreon or the RP, you just want some cool gear, check out our Zazzle store. they've got some cool stuff on there. And that's really all I wanted to say. Games on here usually start around 8 p.m. with the exception of our Monday Q&A, which starts at 9 p.m. Eastern. But yeah, just come check us out. And thank you. Till next time, go forth and roll some dice. Y'all have a good day.
And welcome back to the Obsidian Curtain, where it seems that our party has been inducted into a group. Well, called the Obsidian Curtain. Surprise! And that's all because they found an interesting little note that mentions something called the first spell. So they have been tasked with finding out more information about this and who and what others are trying to do with the first spell. So anyone else want to throw in their 2 cents on what happened in the last game? Besides the fact that I got mileage wrong.
My throat still hurts too much to talk all that, so I'll wait for somebody else.
Shopping spree, shiny gifts.
Yes, y'all did get some new shinies.
Yes, shinies.
Finally, someone stopped bothering us for a net.
Yes. Yes, he finally satisfied his addiction.
Yep. He finally had gotten it.
I never
it.
Said I stopped.
Damn it.
Maybe I'm collecting them. You don't know.
But be all end all, we did some shopping and joined up with the caravan and headed out of town.
Well, you never actually quite made it out of town. Y'all were loading up.
True.
We tested some wands.
And I closed my... And you did. You tested some new wands that you had received. Come on. Can't believe I accidentally closed the document I needed open. The one that has all my notes in it.
Whoops.
All right, so the last y'all left, we left off. Y'all had just started getting ready to hop onto the caravan to leave. As you're loading up, an older dwarven individual comes looking at you. He's got this manifest in his hands, and he's looking at y'all. Were y'all the ones that were headed to Badzul?
Yes.
We're not headed to Vadzul. And at that point, he looks back at the individual y'all had purchased the tickets from.
We look back at him also?
She's new.
So where can we catch a ride to Vadzul?
Well, I know it's kind of short notice, and y'all, he refunds your money. He hands it back to you. So I apologize.
I don't know what it was. Took it off my sheet.
But I've got a brother who works on the Miracle. And they are headed to Vodzul. And he could probably get you passage if you're willing to put in a little work for roughly the same what we were charging here. I mean, it's normally much more when you take an airship, but they'll get you there way quicker than we will on foot.
Okay, I guess that's what we will do then.
Yeah.
All right with flying.
Hey, what?
I'm good for flying, so yeah.
But are you good for putting in the work to do it?
We'll find out.
He will do it. I will make sure of it.
All right, well, I guess tell us where to go. I mean,
all right, you know where the airfield is, right? And y'all know there is a small air dock. Ships coming in and out throughout the day. Yeah, just head over there and you're going to be looking for the Miracle. And you're going to find my brother, Fist.
Vertical Fist. Okay.
Hey.
Fist will be able to help you. Again, my apologies. Freaking idiot.
It's okay.
Now I got to go check the rest.
If you have even one migraine day a week, that's 52 migraine days.
Migraines?
Work time, meal time, bedtimes, family time.
Are you doing? Are y'all hearing anything about a migraine commercial?
Once a month can help prevent migraine.
No.
Oh, no, I am.
It can cut monthly
What?
I was hearing a migraine commercial in my head.
Targeted advertisements?
Yes. Bridgewater. I'm not going to Bridgewater. All right. Yeah. Just Miracle. Ask for Fist. All right. And he turns around and yells back, who's here going to Bridgewater? And you see a couple of people open their hand and he just shakes his head and glares at the girl that y'all dealt with earlier.
All righty then.
Someone got fired.
Or retained.
Yeah, she's probably going to get, hopefully just more training.
Well, I guess we better get moving to the airfield then. This sounds complicated.
Yep. Let's head over there then.
So you make your way towards the airfield. Once there, the hustle and bustle is obvious. Looking at the ships and the thing, you do see one labeled Fist or Miracle. God, I'm getting these names all backwards and everything. So, give me an investigation roll.
On it.
That's not exactly Doma's strong suit. Nope.
I got a nat 20.
Hey.
Oh, shit.
You could have sworn that dwarf that you were talking to at the caravan is directing some people over here. I mean, he's standing in the same pose. He's got a bunch of paperwork, and he's just kind of pointing and directing these dock workers to load up this airship.
Well, I'm going to motion to the group and head on over.
Okay, then.
Yeah, put that one in hold 3. Don't spill any of it. What can I do for you?
Are you Fist?
Yep, I'm Fist.
We were sent here by your brother due to a caravan issue. We need to get to Vuzzle.
My brother from Oaklight Travels?
Yeah.
Let me guess. Katri.
I believe so, yes.
A young girl that...
There was a mix-up with her. She's getting hopefully some new training done.
Well, we'll see. You're that one family member. Just doesn't quite get it. Anyway... So what was the deal? So you're going to Vodzul.
Yeah.
All right. And let me guess. He said we could do it cheap.
For the price that he charged us, yes. Which was around, I think, like 5 gold. For all of us.
5 gold.
What would the regular price be?
It's a gold a mile.
Oh.
For a passenger.
Yeah, we can't.
All right. He starts flipping through his manifest. Any of y'all waited at tables before?
I've waited at tables before.
What about moving stuff? Quarters. All right. Y'all gonna be doing a lot of deck washing.
Okay.
That's okay. I have waited at tables before.
Well, that's good. We'll get you sorted out some more once we get in the air and such.
Yes, sir.
Delcril. And you see this big muscle bound, just like. Oh, half orc. It's got a huge crate on each arm. Just he leans down. A couple of guys pick one of them off and give the other one. Comes walking over.
Yeah, what can I do for you, boss?
Oh no!
No! No! No, no, no. Alexander, shut the fuck up.
Find a room for these individuals. We can get underway. We leave in an hour. Get them settled and get back to work. Show them the ropes.
Yes, sir, boss. Come with me.
I'm following that guy really closely.
Oh. Okay.
So how's it doing?
Bye, Alexander.
Really good.
That's good. So you just started today, huh?
Yeah. You seem like a really happy guy.
Yeah, work's work.
Oh, man. I'm loving this.
All right. And he leads you into equates to a barracks room, a bunk racks. You see several hammocks tied up and several chests. He goes, yeah, just take a chest and take a key. You can do it. We can go from there. Stow your gear away and we'll go move some boxes and stuff.
Uh,
Okay.
We get 3 meals a day. Once we get on way, just cleaning up and helping the passengers, and just making sure the ship doesn't fall out of the sky. I don't want to do that again.
Please tell me that's a joke. Please tell me that's a joke.
No.
And I walk.
But come on, let's go. He has y'all, shows you these chests and such, which you can stow what gear you do have that you don't carry on. You do see that there are people that are armed. But most of them, almost everybody is unarmed. There's no need for them to be.
Are the chests really dirty? Like dusty and stuff?
They're old, they're worn, but they are not like dirty.
Just well used.
Yes. You're getting the equivalent of the, you know, the crew rooms on an ocean liner. It's a 4x4 room, just large enough to sleep in. But so that's basically the amount of space you have to put your stuff.
Okay. So I'm gonna.
After y'all do that, he leads y'all back to the loading bay, and y'all begin to help loading crates and storing them and such.
I hope they have some small ones.
Oh, there's they. In fact, the two of y'all that are minute are given a different task. Make y'all sense. Have become message runners.
Oh, well, that I can do, no problem.
Now you're given, go tell so-and-so this, and just running back and forth, relaying messages.
Bonus that we can fly and avoid traffic.
Yep.
And keep up with the ship.
Did you say ship or sheep? Yeah. There are sheep on board. I'm just asking for clarification. As y'all are working, y'all hardly even noticed when the door to the bay door is closed. Those of you that are not flyers, give me a dexterity check.
Oh, thanks.
As the ship rises suddenly.
Just a check? A 10.
A 10?
A 10.
It's a 10 for me as well.
All right.
15 for me.
15? So the 15, you've actually, Ragnarok, you're like, oh, this is unusual, but you caught it. The other two of you, nobody fell, but
that would be funny.
You did get that sudden lift. Whoa. Whoa. As
that floor got closer all of a sudden.
Yeah, it was you know, just a quick lift. You know, you felt the butterflies in your stomach as it was going up. And then there's the lurch forward as this airship takes to the sky. The rest of your evening is really making sure everything is secure, double checking it. And then you're given a tour of the airship. You've spent most of the time here in the cargo bay. Then you have the cargo bay is basically where the lowliest workers are staying, with all the gear and everything that's here. The next deck up is where most of the staff, cooks, but your other crew members, your higher ranking crew members are at. The actual sailors of this ship stay in the second deck. Third deck is your passenger crew. Fourth deck is a larger open area with an eating area, almost like a little restaurant type thing, just some entertainment stuff for people on the trip. And then you have your exterior, your actual deck of the ship. So you're given a quick little tour, kind of shown some of the things that you're going to be doing. As you get near the edge, you look over and you can see Sicaris far below.
Nice.
Looks really far below.
I see.
Fine.
I can see everything from here.
That's terrifying.
I can see my house from here.
And there it goes. Bye. The air is nice and crisp. Out of the dirty air of the city, all that, the city smells are not here. But while you're up on deck, you're directed to, you know, either move something or clean something, hold on to a rope for a little bit. Not necessarily sure why you're holding on to a rope. You were just told not to let it go or we all die. Just various tasks. You're not sure half of the things you're told to do, because if you don't do them, the ship will fall out of the sky, and you're not sure if it's the sailors fucking with you, or if you let it go, the ship will fall out of the sky. So you're erring on the side of caution.
Can I make an intelligence check to see if I know what I'm doing? Or at least understand what they're saying?
Well, I believe that would be an insight check.
That would That would be an insight check.
Okay, here we go. Wish me luck. Nat 20.
Very nice.
Very nice.
So I understand everything.
No, not necessarily everything.
Because they all have Nat
20. Yeah, but at least
you're not sure.
Why? But I can't understand why. But at least I know they're not telling lies, right?
You're 50-50 on it. So
probably because, you know, you don't know.
You're not a sailor.
You don't know your airship.
And you're definitely not an airship sailor.
I don't think Doma even really realized that these things existed.
Oh, you've seen them. They're airships have only probably been around about maybe 10 years. They're still relatively new, and they've come a long way since they started. know, with a simple balloon, but then once the gnomes started harnessing arcanite and elemental energies, there was all kinds of things that have happened.
The damn gnomes.
Hey, gnomes are everywhere. Between the gnomes and the goblins, everything's being invented.
And the gnomes are only marginally safer.
That's debatable, open to debate. And you're discussing this with some of the other people. They're like, hold on a minute. My understanding is that Clogsgear elects their highest official by the invention. So they make a lot of things out of metal over there. So when things blow up, it's easier to rebuild.
Easier or dangerous? Because if
that
blows up, that means
it contains the contains the explosions. Yeah. Their elected officials are the ones that didn't kill anybody this year. The dangerous experiment.
Yeah, I'll agree. That's a little frightening.
A little?
So you're given the tour, you talked, they show you where to eat. I remember what I have it. Hold on. No, I hit the X, not the other one. I need to pull up.
Can I roll an investigation to see what kind of people are in this ship?
Yes, go ahead.
Come on, DNDB, work with me. That'll be a 22.
Aboard the ship, there's probably close to 100 passengers, if not more.
That's a big ship.
It is a big ship. And so they're all about, most people are staying in their quarters or in the eating area, entertainment lounge, which has got a small library, a little bar. It's kind of like a miniature tavern type thing. Which eventually some of y'all are actually stuck in as barbacks and wait staff. Y'all are end up doing a little bit of everything. But there are Dragonborn, a lot of half-orcs, a lot of goblinoids, hobgoblins, goblins, bugbears. They take up the majority of the populace. Here and there you do see an elf, some gnomes. There are some kobolds. Dwarves. There's just a little mix of everybody. Give me another perception roll.
Oh, yay.
14.
14. There's also a Duergar on ship. Oh, there's another one. Just like your friend.
Oh.
I cut communication with everybody else except for my party and start telling them everything I saw. I saw a couple of your kind.
Are they with, Drow? Out of curiosity.
Do you want me to roll another perception?
Sure, let's see if you see any drow around.
If you're wanting to look for me, you probably won't be.
I have an 18.
You see,
I got a 14.
No drow.
I got a 17.
Well, haven't seen any yet.
All together, though, you do see four Duergar.
How many escape from the house?
One.
One?
We only seen one, yeah.
I could grow many mushrooms from his corpse.
By the way, the staff that you have is now fully looks like a mushroom. No more of that transition. It looks like there's a full-blown mushroom on the top.
Very nice. Excellent. I'm quite happy with that.
You go about your day, night comes. You are worked to the bone tired. You were told that y'all have the morning shift in the cafeteria, in the lunch area, the restaurant part, and y'all will be just not necessarily waiters, but the wait staff, just the porters and the guys that'll come in and clean the tables off and that sort of thing. I forget their names. It's been so long since I've been in a restaurant business.
Bussers.
Bussers, that's right.
And the greeters and all that.
No, you'll be mainly busboys and girls and them's and they's. You'll be cleaning off the tables after the people have eaten. And y'all are woken up early. At least it feels early. And head out to the kitchen. The smells of cooked foods fills the air. There are trays with fruits and the smell of the sorrel. What was it? I'll get the name eventually. Skarik also fills the air.
Skarl, yeah.
And as you're looking over this wondrous feast, you're tapped on the shoulder. Hey, guys, come over here to eat. And, of course, it's the big guy, and he leads you over to a small little room, which has, obviously, other crew members in it. And you're given a bowl that looks like it has some sort of oatmeal in it.
That doesn't look very nutritious.
Well, he said three meals a day. He didn't say anything about being nutritious.
to have you. The meal is very bland, but it fills you up, gives you the energy you need to start bussing tables.
I will use prestidigitation on mine so I can taste better.
It tastes a little bit better, but you know, adding salt to a bad meal just makes it salty.
Anybody want a mushroom?
Are you going to create a mushroom?
Too early to risk it.
I could use Goodberry.
Oh, it's
not the staff. No, I don't want to do that here.
I mean, if you want to use Goodberry, I'll take the berry.
It's still a mushroom, but yeah, that's sure, you can have one.
As you're this, some of the other crew was kind of watching.
Do you want one too?
Yeah, I'll try one.
So, yeah, here you go.
To make us stand out even more than what we are, looking at the food, I'm going to take out my wand of the orchestra, something like that.
Okay.
Playing that while everybody's eating.
With any luck, the crew will love us by the time we disembark.
Yeah.
Yep.
You have your nice little wonderful breakfast that's been musically enhanced. And you head out to the floor. You follow some of the people. He's like, I'll show you what to do. Come on. And team up and they show you how to clear the tables. And you see the one guy, there's like an English muffin that hasn't been eaten, not been touched. So in the process of clearing it off the table, you see him clear it and it goes up a sleeve. So if you want the good food, you got to steal it.
Oh, for real? I cast my shun.
You're casting a spell actually requires. Don't forget
the little
that.
Hands? The little hands? You see the little hands moving.
I thought they were invisible.
Huh?
I thought your little hands were invisible. Your mage hand. Or is that not what you're doing?
No, remember, Drakrins have four hands.
Oh, that. Okay, I misheard. Sorry.
So, while he's
using the little ones to cast the spell.
Yeah.
Exactly. While I'm clearing the tables, you see the little ones like, ha 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 ha. Let me roll a sleight of hand for that because I know it's gonna be impossible. Three queens are so useful sometimes. Dirty 20.
Yeah, nobody sees you. You're able to. You're actually in the process. Something gets brought out to a table and you kind of look over and it looks like some decent fruits. You were actually mage hand the entire dish out without anybody seeing it. So you have a small dish of fruit.
That's awesome.
So I need everyone to give me a perception roll with advantage.
Oh.
Natural 20 for a 23.
16.
I also got 16.
All right, well, the natural 20, you see The as you're going through what was the lowest roll? Who had the lowest roll?
It's probably me.
No? Okay, Domo. Actually, yeah.
That's weird.
Because Domo rolled the 16. The Duergar.
The lowest.
Oh.
That you had seen earlier, that Ragnarok had seen earlier. One of the, they're sitting at a table, the four Duergar, they're sitting with four kobolds. One of the Duergar apparently has some bandages on. Looks like he may have been in a fight recently. Looks like he may have been on the run the last time you see him, saw him with a book.
Oh, dear.
Really?
And Ragnarok.
Yes.
Specifically you, because you saw the traps up close. When you think back on the traps, seeing the kobolds sitting there, you realize that the rapid construction and reckless construction of the traps could only be to kobold engineering. Being able to create a deadly trap out of near nothing and having it shoddily put together is definitely kobold engineering.
I relay the information to the guys. Guys, remember the traps that almost hit me 3-4 times?
Yeah, because you weren't looking. They were funny.
Yeah. They were made by kobolds.
All right.
So,
what about our friend over there?
Exactly.
We're not in the best position at the moment.
We don't have any weapons right now.
Now, did I get a good look at that book? Like, would I know what it kind of looked like?
It's unmistakable.
All right. Would I be able to cast Minor Illusion near his feet without them noticing, and see if he reacts to seeing the book by him?
That is what the book looks like.
Yeah.
Where is it?
It's a mimic.
It was made with the skin of a mimic.
So would that be possible, or not really?
So you want to make it look like the book is at his feet?
Yes. And then somebody walk over to it and, hey, that book looks familiar. See if anything, you know. See if they react.
Well, you can certainly try.
Phew. Minor Illusion.
Okay. As he does that, you said he looks injured still, correct?
Yes.
Okay. I'll go over there.
But he still looks bandaged.
I'll introduce myself as a healer and let him know that I noticed his injuries and see if he'd like me to take care of them real quick.
So they're talking, and in the hushed tones, they stop. And look, what do you want? It's very broken English, or very broken common.
As I said, I just noticed that you looked injured and thought that maybe you would be okay with me tending to your wounds for a moment.
He turns back to his group, says something in Undercommon. Do you speak Undercommon?
I do not.
You do not.
Are any of us close enough?
Are you?
I'm worried that they would recognize me.
I would happily, bus tables nearby just to listen in.
Okay. Angel, what'd you say you were doing?
I said I'm worried that they would recognize me, so I'm off somewhere else.
Staying out of sight? Okay.
Yeah, because I was the other Duergar in the party, so I didn't,
All right, so Doma, you're next to him bussing tables.
Yeah, I would work towards that end.
You hear him say what equates in Undercommon, well, is this fool thinks I need help. Please. He looks back up at you. No, go.
I'll look up at him and shake. I'll look up at him and just shake my head.
So and he knows y'all see him. You see the book on the ground.
It looks like you dropped your book.
Looks down. And let's see how good.
See if he can keep a straight face.
He kind of... For just a split second, you see a glimmer of worry. And like he's trying to think what happened. And he kind of turns and looks, not my book. And he says something else. He says to the rest of them in Undercommon. So Dormer, you hear this. We need to get to the room. And everyone kind of throws their napkins down, stands up, and all eight of them leave.
While they're leaving, I'm going to use my mage hand to steal their room key. That will be what? Stealth or sleight of hand?
That is going to be sleight of hand. And who are you pickpocketing?
The one that has the injuries. He looks like the boss.
All right. Roll your sleight of hand.
Here.
15?
So close.
Don't tell me you failed. Tell me you failed. Tell me you failed.
It was on a natural 20. Skidding across the screen. Then right before it stopped, it rolled.
Oh, I hate when that happens. So
onto a 3. So.
I'll swing back by the rest of the party and just let them know in a low tone where they're headed.
You're able to get a what equates to the key. It's a key of dwarven design. Very intricate. It does have a room number on it.
I tell the party, and I know where they're going. And they cannot enter without this. And I just stand out a little bit, my little hand with the key.
Oh, God.
Oh, that's interesting.
Well, maybe one of us should find out what room they're going to. Because maybe they have another key.
Well, we do have this stealthy rogue in our party.
Yeah.
Who can camouflage.
Mm-hmm.
You guys are throwing me to a wolf. You know that.
No, we'll be behind you.
From a distance.
Hopefully. Okay.
From a distance.
So, I'm gonna use camouflage to use stealth and follow them.
I'm gonna give him some guidance.
Alright.
Nat 20. 27 for my stealth.
So you're able to follow this group down because they don't see you. As you're following them down to the passenger deck. At one point, one of the kobolds stops, puts his head up, starts looking around, looks back, doesn't see you camouflaged into the wall, and rejoins the group. You follow him into the bow of the ship up near the front on the starboard side. And you see the guy you pickpocket is looking for a key. They are talking, but since you don't understand undercommon, I'm not even going to pretend to make the noises for you.
It's okay. Am I within 120 feet of my group?
Only if they followed along with you a little bit.
They say they were, so...
I kind of thought we were trying to do that.
Yeah, we were planning on following, but not enough to where, you know...
Yeah, I can relay the message. So as long as at least one of them is within 120 feet,
okay,
I can talk. So I relay the message like, I think I chose the correct one.
As you say that, you see him getting he gets a little angry. And then turns and starts heading back in your direction.
And hide because they're going your way.
Do you guys think we should go around them? And that way when they come in looking for their key, we can get into their room before they're there?
I need one of you to stay up there and get me watch. When they come back.
And I don't think that all of us should abandon the lunchroom or they'll start looking for the whole group, wondering why we're not doing our jobs.
Exactly.
I would say I wouldn't go, because I was already worried about them noticing me.
So and if perfect. They're coming back this way, I can understand undercommon. So I can do the same thing and just be wandering around, but close enough to overhear.
That... You can fly on in a distance that they don't see you away from the ship, but they can hear. But you can hear them.
Hey, Mordrim, you want to go with Ragnarok with me?
Yeah, I'll go.
Awesome. Okay, so the girls are going to stay in the lunchroom, I guess. And we're going to go with Ragnarok.
Okay.
Sounds like that's what's happening.
Splitting the party.
Yeah,
but we're not attacking anyone right yet.
Yet. So, who's going where again? Who's doing what?
I think Mordrim and I are going around, like, trying to wait for them to pass us. And then we're going down to Ragnarok.
Okay, so y'all are going to Ragnarok, and the others are following?
No, we're staying in the lunchroom.
Okay, staying in the lunchroom. All right.
I think we'll call if we need help.
All right. Yeah, so,
when they are in range, I can telepathically tell, like, help.
Is anybody following the Duergars?
Right now, no.
Okay.
I'm staying down there in the room, close to the room, so they're gonna pass through. I'm gonna hide, behind a crate while I'm stealthy. And let them pass me so I can enter the room as soon as they are out of sight. Well, and count until five, they are out of sight, so I'll make sure.
Okay. So, as this goes on, those of you in the lunchroom do eventually see the Duergar come up and pass out. Through another area.
Then I'm gonna enter the room.
I'm gonna start making my way down.
Doma, should you follow?
Hang on a second. Oh, that's really high. Okay. Doma has this random thought that it's quite possible that the people who run the ship would be smart enough to have spare keys somewhere, and he may be going for one.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking they're doing.
So, I look around the lunchroom. Does it look like, maybe one of us could make an excuse to head the same direction they're heading without causing too much ruckus?
Yeah, you could probably get away with that.
Okay, grab a tray, throw a couple of towels on it, and follow them down the hall.
Okay, so you're going?
Yeah, I mean, you're worried about them recognizing you.
I mean, you're also a fairy, I'm kind of worried they'd recognize you.
I didn't exactly go face to face with them, so I don't know, but I think we gotta know something.
I don't know. All right, good luck.
Yeah, thanks. Gonna need it. So I will follow and try not to look like I'm following. Look like I have somewhere else to go.
All right.
What would you like me to roll, if anything?
Just give me a stealth roll.
Okay. Dice be kind. Yeah. 13.
13.
I mean, I'm not trying to hide, just not look like I'm following them.
Just not being noticed.
Yeah. Just another person doing their job on the ship.
Okay. You're able to do so. You're not, no one's paying any mind to you. My nose is clogged up completely.
Servants are typically ignored. I'm banking on it.
And yes, they appear to be hunting down someone. As you follow along, you eventually see Thrist. And another key. All right.
Hold on.
I'm taking this in sections here. So Thrist goes off to obviously get them another key. Now, after they left, you, Ragnark, go down. Are you going to wait for the others to come to you? Or are you going to go ahead and just enter the room?
I see them gone. I'm going to go inside. We have to do this. This is a time-based mission. We have to get in, get out. So I'm going to go in. I'm going to get in ahead. I have the key.
Then I'm going to say, Mordrem, I thought we said we were going to come down and go in together, but all right, I guess not.
We are in a time base. I need one of you to be my...
We can't respond back to you.
Yeah, but I'm saying to myself over here as out of character. Like, we are in a time base right now, so sorry, guys. So I get it.
Go down.
Exactly.
Well, Mordrem.
All right.
I'm coming.
As you open the door that you didn't check for traps on again.
That a bunch of
people. Is there a map?
Huh?
Besides, this is a ship.
Yes.
Why do they have traps inside the ship?
Because there's kobolds making them.
I was going to say...
That's what us kobolds do, man.
I was going to refrain for traps, but it's too late, so yeah. Uh-huh. What do you need?
Nothing. I just wanted to state that out. This is a... Compared to your compartment down below... This is a nice room. You can see that there has been some remodeling done with the furniture. A desk, a table, and some chairs have been maneuvered around in what would almost be a children's fort.
That's kobold.
And, but other than this, this is a really nice room. This is a very expensive room.
Huh. Well, I'm looking for the book.
So just to get an idea, we'll do some old school, scratch drawings on paper.
Those are the best.
Because I did not make a map of the rooms yet.
You didn't expect me to go to ink so quickly.
All right. Oh, I need. Okay, so this little bitty corner over here on the owlbear. The door into the room is right here. There is a bed here.
Okay.
A bed here. The little kobold thing. They've actually got a pretty good little fort built right here. And then this is like a wardrobe. Like a little closet.
Okay. So I start checking the closet first. What do you want me to roll?
It's going to be an investigation roll.
Oh, not one.
A nat one. You won't find anything in the closet.
Maybe some dirty socks. Okay, then I'm gonna check. Do I see the the bowls where we get our things? Do I see any of things? You know, the chests?
Where you see any things? You don't see any.
Cobalt layer. Investigation. That's a good one, 25.
You see the mouth of the kobold fort, and you're about to start to go through there, but then you see a thin piece of thread between two of these chair legs.
Okay. Is that the book?
No, it's a thin piece of thread between two chair legs.
Ooh.
You're thinking it may be trapped.
Is it a book?
Sorry. I thought he said, what? Sorry. Okay. I'm gonna disarm it.
Okay.
Actually, no. Can I wait, on top of it without tripping it? You know, still made it there, but not tripping it.
You're gonna try to bypass the trap.
Yes.
All right. Give me a dexterity roll. You can use acrobatics if you have it.
Yes. That's an 11.
That's an 11. Unfortunately, 11 was not quite good enough, sir. As
the dog started barking.
Didn't hear it.
I muted it. They getting excited.
So, Ragnarok, you're going to take 7 points of damage as you are carefully trying to get through this kobold-sized hole without setting off this trap with your medium-sized body. Peek back in here. You move one of the chairs just enough to cause tension on that. As a as something hits you in the thorax, looking down, you see what appears to be part of a broomstick handle that's got two daggers tied to it with straw. And apparently that they were spring-loaded, so you take 7 points of damage as these two daggers swing around and just stab into you.
Damn it.
But in there now, you see in the center of this mess of kobold treasury is a chest. Probably about twice the size of what the book was.
Now, would we be getting down close to him at this point?
Yes. Y'all enter the room right as you hear in Thrycreen.
Where would the door be? Right at that top blue line? That little one?
Yeah.
So, like, right around here?
For the door. Yes. Yes, you're right there at the door. I'm sorry.
All right. So, would I see these traps that he set off so far?
It's inside this cave of wonders that would have been built by the kobolds.
Well, I'm going to wait for Mordrem to get in the door.
Yeah, I'll get in the doorway. I wouldn't be too hard on.
Yeah.
Domer, are you still
investigation?
Domer, are you still following?
Doing my best to remain within earshot, yes.
All right. You see them go back into a small little office. And you hear him, the bandaged one, go, "Is my object still locked up?" Thris turns, pulls out this case, sets it on the table, and unlocks it. Ragnar. So you're looking over this case. It's about twice the size of the book.
I'm going to do an investigation on it. That was a 16.
That was a 16. All right. Hold on just a second here.
You know, I like the running theme of this rogue of ours constantly failing traps.
The rogue that never fails to activate a trap.
It looks like a chest. Are you checking it for traps or something?
I know what mimics are. I'm checking if it's alive first. Although I don't have my weapons with me, so I better not.
But you may know what I've already said, but your character doesn't. So how are you checking this?
I still have fruit.
Okay.
I'm gonna get out here. Place a fruit in front of the chest and get out.
Okay.
Actually, no. I put, make my mage hand put the fruit while I'm outside. Put the fruit in front of the chest.
Okay.
And with so, the digitation, make it smell like meat.
Okay. Nothing happens.
I make my mage hat put the fruit on top of the chest, just in case.
All right, it's a piece of fruit sitting on top of the chest.
Okay.
Here, you could try to open it. I'm going to cast guidance on him again.
I'm going to use my mage hand to open the chest.
And then I am going to back out the door and around the corner.
You're an ass. So what will be? Sleight of hand?
To open the chest?
Yeah.
No, just open the chest.
With my mage hand?
Yeah, you can. Are you using your mage hand to open it?
Yeah, it is. Is it unlocked?
As far as you can tell, it's unlocked.
Okay. So with my mage hand, I'm going to open it.
All right. The chest opens.
Nothing happened? Okay, I'm gonna go get inside again. Wait, the trap is already set, so I can pass through it without problems, right?
Yep, you've already set off the trap.
Okay, perfect. I'm gonna look inside the chest. Investigation.
As you look inside the chest, there's a book.
The same book I'm looking for?
Looks just like the book you were looking for.
Oh boy.
Mm-hmm. Doma, as he opens the case, looks in just for a glimpse. Looks like the book is in the case.
I thought as much. Okay. I can't do anything about it right now. I'm just going to make note. Let's see where he puts it away. Assuming I can do so unobtrusively.
Give me a perception roll.
Okay. Yay. Come on, be kind. Hey, 19.
You are able to see him put the small case into a larger setup, and you can see where on the wall he has stored it with other stuff that's in there.
Make a mental note. Okay.
And then after a moment, you see him, he hands them over a key, and they start to head back out.
Okay. I will find something to
all right
pass me by.
Ragnar and the others.
Yes. I'm gonna tell the others that found it. Then I'm gonna make my mage hand grab it, because I'm not gonna touch that book.
Okay.
And get out.
Right about there, you're going to stop. Just for a moment.
I feel left out.
So, oops. Here, let me make this a little more proper.
I like that.
Let's see. Oh, wait a minute. Yeah. That's 5, 15. Okay, it's actually that big.
Nice.
Ragnar, as your mage hand lifts the book, give me an arcana roll.
Arcana?
Arcana.
E. 14?
14. You're not exactly sure what you see, but on the sides of the case on the inside, you see these glyphs light up right before a large burning flash and flame engulf you.
Yep.
So I need a dexterity saving throw.
So was it a fireball?
Guidance, what is the guidance? The die for guidance?
Add a d4.
D4, thank you, just in case. Okay, dirty 20.
All right. So you made your save.
Whew.
But. Let's see. You're still taking 10 points of fire damage as a fireball suddenly erupts.
It wasn't me. Not yet.
By the way, there's also now a small hole in the ship.
I tell Mordor and Alexander, ouch, run. And my mission gave me the book and I start running.
All right. Make sure to lock the door behind you.
Done. Yeah, like that's gonna, you know.
Well,
at this way, as you come out of the hallways, other people are starting to, that are in the neighboring rooms, you're coming out looking around trying to figure out what's going on. The whole ship shudders.
I'm using stealth with advantage because I'm 11 for real, goddammit.
So what are y'all doing? Doma, as you're... sorry. Doma, as you're off to the side, as they pass you by and the ship shakes, you hear somebody's in the room and they all take off running.
We hide.
Angel, you're in the mess hall still, and the shake. People are freaking out in here. Moments later, after the shaking, you see the Duergards and the kobolds passing through to head back downstairs.
She just groans because she realizes.
Are there any crates in the hallway? Any boxes at all?
Not where y'all are at. Y'all are more in the passenger side of the ship right now.
All right.
Storage is down below.
Gotcha.
But I start heading down the hall as well.
You do see crew members trying to calm down people, but there are people freaked out.
I use prestidigitation to make a... Can I create, like, smoke?
There's probably already smoke.
There is already smoke and fire in a room.
So more smoke, so people can freak out more, and we can blend with the people.
That's not the worst idea.
So it's a bug that probably smells like a burnt bug.
Exactly. So, Mordrum, a little bit healing, please. And I use prestidigitation to use more smoke. To create more smoke. So, maybe I'm going to need a little bit more help with prestidigitation here.
Yeah, you can do. I mean, you can create a little bit, but you're not. The amount you're talking is going to take more than prestidigitation.
Do prestidigitation at the same time?
There's other spells for this type of thing.
It's prestidigitation is more like poof, smoke in your hand, or
cast minor illusion to make it look more like smoke.
Minor illusion would work.
Okay, so I
can to a degree, but yeah, in the panic they would probably fall for it.
Okay, I cast minor illusion, so create a lot of smoke.
Just fill it up with a static image of smoke. Okay, people are thoroughly freaking out. You see one of the crewmen go down and get trampled a little bit.
We using that crew over there because they're the most desperate, so they would try to get away from that crew over there. So we going with that crew. Get going, guys. Blending with those over there. Alexander, get between me so I can protect you with my arms and they don't see you flying.
Yeah.
All right.
Meanwhile, I will duck back into the lunchroom and go inform Wildstrike of what I've just seen.
All right, Wildstrike headed downstairs.
Well, then I'll follow Wildstrike then.
Yeah, I'm heading that way until I see.
Are they within reach? Are they within reach of 120 feet?
Yes. Yes.
Okay, I'm gonna tell everybody. Okay, we're meeting in the service room.
Do you have the book?
Yes.
Okay, maybe you should say that too.
I have the book.
No, you don't.
You cannot tell me that.
I know, but I will as soon as I see you.
Robbie?
Yes.
Hold on a minute. I gotta look up, but I think it's an intelligence saving throw. It could be a wisdom.
Even better.
Mordrum, oh. Where's the healing?
Now, as we go, can I cast...
Yeah, I'll cast Cure Wounds on you.
And then can I cast Prestidigitation on Ragnarok to make all the burn and the blackness go away?
You get 8 points of healing back.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. My carcass is already black.
Yeah, I'm trying to clean you off a little bit so you don't look all burnt.
Thank you.
I'm sitting here trying to find this, and I'm looking in the wrong thing, and it keeps telling me it's not there. If my book itself wasn't falling apart, I would use it, but... Robbie, give me now that you give me a perception roll with advantage.
Two.
Robbie, Ragnarok.
16.
As you're making your way through the hall and you're holding this book tightly, you're like, you know, with all those jagged edges on there, this thing shouldn't feel this smooth. You look down at the book and it looks like the book, but it doesn't feel like the book. And then you get jumbled again as y'all make y'all's way to the group area. Am I still on the air?
Yes.
All right. What do y'all?
So what the hell did y'all do?
Wasn't me.
And I don't think you have the book.
And Robbie, as you look at it now, the image of the what the book is supposed to look like almost looks translucent over what appears to be just an old book. The rest of y'all see, at first see the book. Give me an intelligence slash investigation or perception roll even. I'll go with that.
Do I still need to roll one?
Yes.
12.
A nat 20.
Yeah. No, but that's just a brown book he's carrying. you see a, so, a 12. You're looking at this and you see it looks like the book.
Oh boy.
That is so not the book. I know where the book is.
Where is it?
It's in the secured lockbox.
Oh, nice.
And I'll tell them, you know, how I followed and what I saw.
As y'all see this book more and you're hearing what Domer's telling, you're able to perceive past the illusion that is surrounding this book and see that it's just a brown book.
This mother... Where's my crossbow?
No, I'm gonna look at Ragnar. Failed more traps, huh?
Yes, he
Shut did. Up.
He even blew a hole in the ship.
Oh, I'm so just that's gonna look at,
I'm gonna just look at her and say, shut up. And look down, like embarrassed.
Maybe he's going for the record for most number of traps sprung.
All of them.
Well,
I know how to take him out. I just put traps in there, and I'm sure that I can take him out.
I thought bugs were supposed to be, you know, sneaky.
He's a
I was sneaky. I didn't see that trap.
So now the question is, what do we do?
You hear some of the crew starting to come back down because it's been dead down here. There hasn't been anybody down here. They've been all called up to help calm the passengers. But you hear Thriss start barking out orders about getting some lumber and to try to make repairs and the such.
I will go assist and use mending to help fix the side of the boat, the ship.
All right. Even with mending, it is... Huh?
I said I'll join in on that. I know mending is going to take forever and not really do much, but... to help the suspicion.
So y'all mentioned threat. Oh, y'all can mend a little bit? Oh, that'll be helpful. The only casters we have are up with the engine.
Yeah.
I go there, pick up some lumber, and use my mage hand to help me with the other side. So it looks like I'm carrying a lot of lumber by myself, but my mage hand is helping me on the other side.
All right. And right here, we're going to take a small bathroom break, because I need one.
Yay! Me too.
Alrighty.
So we'll be back in just a little bit. Let's go back to commercial!
Commercial!
Good morning, my Mimic Army. I am the AMDM Lee, and this is my cup of coffee. Which I'm out of. So what I'm doing here is actually giving you kind of a little update about what we do here, what we have on our Discord server, as well as what we do here on Twitch. First off, on Monday nights, we have our Q&A. This is set up at 9 p.m. Eastern, where we take questions both on here on Twitch, as well as live stream it on TikTok, and with our Discord patron support, asking questions about either about my homebrew world, about D&D in general, or we just BS about nerdy stuff. That's all it is. No requirements, nothing else, just somebody talking and having a good time for an hour or two. After that, we come across to our Black Door game, where a group of assassins have set out into the world. Now, what's unique about this game is almost all of the classes that are being played are homebrew subclasses or completely new homebrew classes. They were made by one of our mods and on our Discord server, and this is kind of it's really a playtest game. It's been a lot of fun. They've come across a few little adventures trying to figure out what they're going to do in the world. Come check it out. Like I said, it's a lot of fun. Next up, we have on Wednesdays and Thursdays are usually my days of rest for when I try to play games. Now, Thursday will be changing soon. I have to get some scheduling issues corrected out, but we will be starting a new campaign soon, strictly for certain Patreon members. Now, this will not be a bunch of one-shots like our Friday night game. It will be a full-blown campaign delving into some of the deeper lore on my homebrew world. But then that brings us to Friday. Friday is some of the funnest games I've ever played. There are a series of one-shots for our Order of the Scale. Now, this game is 100% first come, first serve to our Patreon supporters. It goes every Friday night from 8 p.m. to usually around 11. And I never know exactly who's playing, what they're playing, what class they are, what level they are. But it's a lot of fun. It's a lot of fun for me anyway. But I just wanted to cover these things with you. I wanted to let you know what we do, why we're here. And I wanted to, and also take this moment to say thank you. Thank you for your support. Thank you for watching. If you would like to support and you haven't yet, there are multiple ways to do so. One of which is using your Amazon Prime Twitch account. If you've got Amazon Prime and you're not using your free Twitch subscription, I'd be more than happy to use it. Another way you can support us is with our join us on Patreon. That gives you access to a lot more stuff. Believe me, there's a lot more stuff. You also get early access to any homebrews we create, all kinds of goodies on there. But if that's not quite your cup of tea and you're wanting to get a little bit more out of it, you can come check out our Zazzle site, where you can get cool things like this bandana. This is a battle map bandana. It's set out in grid work, and there are other maps that I've been designing and getting ready to publish out on there. We have t-shirts. You can get yourself an AMDM t-shirt. You can get yourself a Mimic. There's some Mimic Army stuff coming soon. So yeah, if you want to support us, but you don't want to do the Patreon or the RP, you just want some cool gear, check out our Zazzle store. They've got some cool stuff on there. And that's really all I wanted to say. Games on here usually start around 8 p.m. with the exception of our Monday Q&A, which starts at 9 p.m. Eastern. But yeah, just come check us out. And thank you. Till next time, go forth and roll some dice. Y'all have a good day. And we're back. All right. So, we'll discuss fairy glitter at another time. So y'all, a few of y'all have gone to assist with the repairs to the hull of this large ship. What are the others of y'all doing?
I imagine, considering the cost of passage aboard this ship, that there's quite a few rich people who just have the vapors and need some spirits delivered.
All right. You do see, as y'all are making y'all's way through back and forth, you do see the Duergar. Three of the Duergar and the four kobolds are sitting at one table. The other Duergar, who appears to be the leader, is speaking with someone dressed. If this was a military vessel, you could assume that they were the one in charge. So this is obviously the captain of the ship. You see them all in the as you're walking by, you can see them through the window into the lounge part.
Okay, so is there any chance of overhearing part of their conversation?
Give me an investigation roll or perception roll. I will take either or.
Okay. Nope. It's just too noisy. That was a 7.
There's too much going on.
Do either of them look angry or?
They both look visibly agitated.
Well, I mean, the hole got blown inside in the side of the captain's ship. I assume he's angry.
Oh, he's.
Who did it?
He is. He's got the customer service face on.
Of course.
He's making apologies, but you can't make out exactly what all's being said.
Right.
He'll say something, the dwarf will get an angry look. The dwarf will say something, he'll get an angry look. It seems to be a back and forth between the two of them.
Yeah, of course. Okay.
So those of y'all that are in the room mending,
Yeah.
Get names so easily. Drakil is in there with y'all as well. Make sure you're hooked up to your harnesses. I can't remember the voice I did earlier. That's how bad the voices are in my head. They keep changing. And he's making sure that y'all are harnessed so you don't fall out of the hole to your death.
Does the harness fit me?
He has got a string.
Oh, look, you're a kite.
Let me see something.
Fairy glitter time.
He actually fashioned, and you're not sure how he did this, but a small harness out of string so to keep you from getting sucked out of the ship.
This is much appreciated.
And we're talking, you know, his fingers are like, his fingers are this big around. I mean, they're just a huge guy. But this little harness is just so intricately done. You got the safe, the 4 points of contact. It's a snug harness. He also collects glass figurines, by the way.
Of course.
So y'all are working on this. He's like, man, wonder what could have blown a hole in the wall.
No idea. It looks
I would like somebody to know was too.
Rearranging things in the room.
Yeah. Some of these rich folks, you never can't tell what they're planning. Bunch of weirdos, if you ask me.
Is this a common occurrence?
Holes being blown? No! I've got his voice back. I don't know why you think that.
I didn't think it was. I was just wondering.
As I'm busy delivering spirits, can I pilfer a bottle for later?
Give me a sleight of hand check.
Okay.
Everyone's stealing shit.
Come on, we need it. How about a 16?
You're able to get a bottle. It's not the greatest, but it's...
But it's not nothing.
It's not $2 hooch. No, it's not Boone's Farm.
Your lawful good paladin's going to assume that you just took that and paid for it.
I did, in labor.
Did.
I think your lawful
good paladin.
Help us here.
With y'all's
help us here, paladin. Over here.
With y'all's help, they're able to patch the hole to the point where nobody can die by coming into the room.
Too bad.
Well, that's good, I guess.
And y'all...
Can we make an escape route so we can open it again when they're inside and make them fly?
What?
Oh my god.
Don't think anybody's going to be going back into the room. Nobody will be staying in that room. So between the little bit of chaos y'all have created... The day comes to a close. You're fed slightly better. You're fed a thick and hearty stew for dinner. But or for lunch, it's not even near dinner time yet. Are y'all going to just go about helping around throughout the day? Or what are y'all going to do?
If we're off duty, I'm going to grab a nap.
So y'all are just gonna continue helping out through the day? Yep. All right. So y'all finished your day of work. Grueling, exciting, explosive. You're left to your own resources now as the evening has come. What is y'all's plan?
Do we end? Do we wait a little bit, or do we want to try to get into the office to retrieve the book?
More than likely, I expect there will be someone posted there. I mean, I would.
Then I honestly think we might want to wait to do that until how long is it going to take us to get to? Do we know how long it would take us to get to where we're going?
3 days.
Okay. Just want to make sure.
It's amazing how fast you can travel by airship. I figured it up. It's like, it's literally almost exactly 3 days, 3 day trip.
Okay, perfect. But it might be best for us to wait until closer to the end of our trip so, you know, we don't just get thrown off the ship if we get caught. Or, you know, jail.
If you get thrown off, how many of us can fly?
Two of them.
I mean, I can fly a little bit.
Unless they clip your wings. You know.
So you're just going to sacrifice me and the bug. Okay.
Look, I'm just saying hypothetically. Like,
jeez. That'd be the next trap he would hit. The ground.
Yep. The falling damage alone would be beautiful.
Go from Thrycreen to Thrycrater.
Go from Thrycreen to whipped cream. What are you talking about?
Well, I mean, in that case, why don't we just chill for the evening? You know, well, I'll pull out the bottle and share it around and everybody can relax for a minute.
Yeah, I think we just need to hold off on activities in case another big boom goes off.
I do think one of us needs to work on getting to be able to work in that office with the book.
Okay. Who is the most persuasive here?
Oh god, well, that's probably me.
Definitely not me.
What was that?
Who is the most persuasive here?
Oh, that's probably me.
Persuasive? I got a plus 5 on persuasion.
Oh, so do I. I got a plus 5.
I also have a
plus 5 to my deception.
Well, then, you might be the better option.
Yep.
Well, anybody can also have another D4 added to that plus inspiration. So that's plus a D6 and a D4.
So, but why? Okay. How would I end up in a job in the office?
Bursar's office, yeah.
They put us out here, lowest of the low work.
They didn't say that we can rise to the ranks.
Well, what skills?
We're only going to be on the ship for like 3 days. You think they're going to let some stranger in their office?
Well, we did just help keep the ship from, you know, falling apart.
Yeah, but
yeesh.
It still just doesn't seem like, I don't know if they would allow that, and I don't even know how to approach them saying, hey, can I wear this? That sounds fishy.
The best bet in that case would be a one-shot trying to disguise yourself as one of the party of Durger.
I mean,
as far as I can tell, that'd be like the only option.
Alright, well, I'll try to dress up like a Durgar then.
Were any of them female Duergar? Or are they all male?
From a Durgar's perspective, they were all male.
Oh. I probably can't look like that.
So we would have to take one out and have you replace them.
Oh, boy. Because I don't have any sort of disguising magic.
I have disguise self. I can make, I think, eyes on self. God damn it.
That's for you there, buddy, yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, do you want to try to play the part of a giant turtle?
No.
I mean, I wouldn't mind it trying for this job, but at the same time, whenever we think about how everything was set up and based on what was set, I doubt they'll let a stranger, even if we did help rebuild the hole in the ship, into the office.
Yeah, I tend to agree with you.
Especially if it's meant to keep, because I doubt that's going to be the only belonging that's locked up.
Do we have
a lot of rich people are on here? They probably have stuff locked up.
Do we have anything that would show that that book doesn't belong to them?
I would say probably not. It would be our word versus theirs.
Do you have invisibility?
Me? No.
Because we can put something inside there. Something that we can say is of value and we need to save. And if she's invisible.
Hey, I have another idea. What if we put one of or two of the fairies in a box? Say, hey, can you store this in the office?
They're gonna see the object before storing it.
Well, you can leave it unlocked and you can say, don't open this.
I think after something just blew a hole in the side of the ship, that they're going to be a little bit more suspicious than that and be like, well, what are you putting in here, bud?
I could minor illusion it to make it look like...
I was going
to
say, you can, if you really want to do this box thing, we can stuff you two in there and you can cast minor illusion to cover up the...
Yeah.
I don't know if I want to be stuck in a box with a flame wing. Like a just saying.
All right, well, what's y'all's plan?
I said my piece.
Let's sleep on it tonight and talk about it tomorrow.
All
right. You know, once all the adrenaline drains out.
All right. Y'all have a nice long rest. And you're awoken the next morning to repeat the day before. Bussing the kitchen and then various tasks around the ship for the rest of the day.
Keeping an eye out for our Duergar friend and his pals, and just in case, keep tabs on them when we see them.
All right, you do notice that apparently they were given another room.
That tracks.
that's on the other side of the ship. The captain figures if it happens again, at least it'll be a match.
Now, would I be able to ask to be harnessed again and then go try to clean the windows off so I can see if they're doing anything in the room?
We really don't do the outside until we make dock. It's too dangerous.
Figured those people who, you know, spend a lot of money, you know, would like to have clean stuff, but all right.
You know, if they want a clean window, they can go out and do it, but we're not going to.
I don't blame him.
No.
So you see the Durgar and just bussing tables.
Wait, the Durgar is not bussing
tables? Y'all are bussing tables and being sent around for various tasks. Anything y'all want to do while y'all are on these various tasks?
Well, would I be getting to deliver any messages to people?
Yes.
Lovely. Then I am going to ask to do that as much as possible.
Okay.
Just to see if I can see anything or hear anything while doing that.
What are you looking for, and where are you kind of... I'm giving you the options here of doing jobs in certain areas to try to get information. So y'all are going to let me know what you're looking for and where.
So I would be mostly looking down in the passenger quarters, looking for anything like open doors to where I might be able to see in to see if there's any Durgar or kobolds that are moving things around again.
Give me an investigation roll.
You know, that's not the best one.
I'm thinking I could possibly join like a brass polishing crew and work my way down the hallway toward the bursar's office.
11.
All right. So 11, most of the rooms, you see people coming and going out of the rooms, but you don't see any Durgar.
I would also ask if they would like me to make their beds.
There's a couple of people that are like, yeah, go on. And then there's a couple of people that just insist that they want their room turned down and ready before they come back. Now that they've seen you flying around.
Sure. I'll do that too.
All right. So Dorma, what were you?
So considering, again, you know, a ship full of high-end passengers, I'm sure there's plenty of, like, you know, brass fixtures and whatnot that need polishing, etc. So I'll see if I can't hook up on that crew and work my way down the hallway towards the bursar's office just to verify, you know, that they probably have a guard or person of attendance of some sort.
Yeah, you do see an armed uniformed officer standing in front of that office.
Don't you get bored staying here all day while I polish whatever's nearby?
Nope. I like my job. Move over.
Nothing wrong with that.
Every time you step, just make one small little movement towards the door. You see, he's like waiting for you to cross some invisible barrier so he can draw his weapon and go to town on you. He's that guard, you know? Just wait. One more step and I'm going to whoop his ass. You know?
Security guard on a power trip. Okay.
Yeah.
Man, how long do you have to stay here all day?
Till my shift's over. Don't you got work to do? Go on.
I am working. See, I got to polish this knob right here.
Well, do a job and be quiet.
Sorry. Just, you know, some people have really long shifts. You kind of feel sorry for them.
He just starts ignoring you.
All right.
All right, Sifu, or Ragnark.
Yes.
What are you doing?
Well, I'm actually gonna be doing the rooms, cleaning them and all that.
Okay.
I will be with the room service.
Okay. So, what are you going to just be going from room to room?
Yep.
Okay. So, who else was doing the room to room? Was it Alexander? So, you eventually run into Alexander, and y'all are both now kind of teamed up a little bit going the room, doing the room service thing. Wild Strike.
Yeah.
What are you doing?
I really don't know. Probably just gonna just go where they need me.
Alright, you gonna try to gather any information?
I mean, I'll listen, but if I'm not wanting to get close to the Durbar, so.
Okay.
Especially the one that we had the encounter with.
So, just going around there, you catch rumors of some explosion that happened, and rumors that it may be Robbie. Can you mute yourself for a moment? The explosion may have been a bomb. You hear stuff, everything from a terrorist organization to a drug lab being run on the ship by the crew. Some people are saying that it was a dragon that did it. And that's a whole chain of rumors going that this is just the places or the ship's way of trying to milk more money out of them. Just, you know, various talk back and forth.
Okay.
Huh. Not a robbery gone wrong. Huh.
Well, that's a good thing.
Yeah, you
I know,
it.
But...
Where'd Mordrum go?
A dragon?
I'm not sure. He fell offline.
Yeah, because I was about to ask Mordrum what they're doing here.
I'm not catching any rules to do with, other things on the ship?
Like? What do you,
other than the explosion, so if, I'm wondering if there's, like, you know, rumors on where, other than the office, like, where things could be kept, or...
Okay.
Yeah.
So give me a perception roll.
Oh, boy. Okay, yeah. That's gonna be lovely.
Because you're kind of listening more...
A nine.
You're not hearing of any other place that they would hold valuables.
Okay. Yeah, so the idea of me getting that office job is definitely most likely not going to be a thing.
Never hurts to ask. You know, you gotta dress the part. So your day continues on, and you get your off time. You're making your way out on the deck, just wandering a little bit. You can see as you're high above, small little pinpoints of light here and there of small villages or homesteads, farmlands. And in the far distance, you can see the mountains starting to loom towards you. It won't be long before you make it to Valdez. Just Vodzul, swapping letters. And the book is still out and about, or not within your hands. So what are y'all's plans for the evening?
Take over the ship.
Well,
the same thing we do every night, Pinky.
That's why I say take over the ship.
Perhaps in our free time we could just walk around.
Yep.
So what are y'all hoping to accomplish is what I'm... What do y'all... You walk around and... Are y'all going to try to gather any more information? Are you going to try to make a play for the book?
I am going to make a point of passing by the bursar's office again and see if the shift has changed and who may be there now.
There is a different individual there.
All right. See if he's a little more chatty.
He's still standing. He's standing there like the other one was. He's not quite... He doesn't look quite as jumpy.
Gotcha.
But he's standing very stoic.
Ah, okay.
So I'm going to fly up, land next to her, say, question for you. Does being a guard on this ship pay pretty well?
Yeah.
Would you think I have a chance of, doing this kind of job? Like being a guard on the ship, maybe next time it goes out on a flight.
Are you one of the merchant families? Are you in real blood, anything like that?
I do know quite a few merchants.
So probably not.
Well, my girlfriend and I were trying to join the Mile High Club. Would you mind letting us pass by and I'll hold out 20 gold?
You just got... Okay. Hang on. I need a I need a deception roll from you, Alexander. And Dorm,
How would you like to respond to what you hear this? Are you going to continue to act along with it? Or...
Now, would I be taking advantage with this because I'm holding out 20 gold or no?
Well, hold on.
After nearly choking for a moment, you know, choking that bile back down, I will go ahead and play along for the moment.
Okay.
But he will pay later.
Are you going to be, let's go with deception then.
Yeah, I'm not good at that, but okay. Yeah, no, that's a 6.
So, he's looking, he looks at you, and as soon as you say that, he sees her face, he kind of looks back at you and, go away. Oh, that was a 1? Oh, no, that was something else.
For a con save, I think she was throwing up.
Oh, okay.
Actually, that was an accidental click, but that works too.
Yeah, my deception was a 21.
Yeah.
She's just nervous.
Go away. All right, your deception could be okay. You absolutely believe that. She doesn't.
Well,
yeah, that's not something you spring on your girlfriend.
Hey, it was worth a shot. I mean, so one of the last nights on the ship.
I'll turn to him and I will slap him across the face and it's like, don't surprise me with that kind of crap.
Shh.
I think I fall over from the smack.
He's just standing there.
Yeah. He didn't sign up for drama. I'll dock off back down the hallway.
Then I'm going to fly up and sit on the railing next to the guy saying, another loveless night. How about you, man? Got anybody at home?
I believe you're being ignored.
Gonna take out the one pyrotechnics. Shoot it off into the air a couple times.
Okay.
It's the only thing that brings joy to me right now.
When it goes off, he actually draws his weapon, his sword, and starts yelling at you to get back. Get back! Get back! Guards! Get back!
Just a wand.
Yeah.
Those little fireworks. But I'll back away.
And at this point, those of you dormer, you're still there, you hear the word, you hear somebody yell guards coming from behind you.
Oh Jesus. I will turn back around. And I will come back up the hallway. What did you do now?
I was playing with fireworks.
And you hear other people coming down the hallway now. So what are the others of y'all doing?
Probably investigating why we were hearing explosions.
Same.
Yeah, because you can hear it from like 100 feet. 300 feet, yeah. So there are several individuals headed to where y'all are at. And several of them are armed. Yelling at, they're pointing at you, Alexander. Put it on the ground! On the ground!
Okay. I'll blast it at my feet. See, it's harmless. It's just light.
Yeah, what's your armor class?
11.
Okay.
Lordy, my parents were right about you.
So that is a 16 to hit.
Yep, that hits.
Oh, I'm sitting here trying to hunt it down, and I know I've got it right here. So I think I just lied. No, there it is. Okay, I was right.
You're humming the A-Team theme song.
Yeah, I know.
That's disturbing.
So that is 4 points of bludgeoning damage as one of the guards comes up to the side and hits you with a shield.
Yeah. What was that for?
Shh. Get on the ground! Get on the ground!
I'm on the ground. I'm 2 feet tall.
I know. And they're trying to actively restrain you. One of the guards kicks the wand over.
But
I am not interfering because that would be like the worst possible thing right now.
Doesn't do anything. It's just light. Didn't you hear the little crackle sound? Fireworks.
Yeah, fireworks blew out the hole in the ship. Get him down.
I just put it at my feet. I'll lay down on the ground. Be like, look, there's
nothing. No, you're not. What do you mean you're going to lay down on the ground? You are restrained.
Well, you say get on the ground, so I was getting on the ground.
So they're still restraining you. They're yelling that while they're throwing you to the ground, basically.
Yeah. So look, there's not even burn marks. I just blasted at my own feet. There's nothing.
Take him to the brig. So are you going to go compliantly or are you going to resist?
Well, yeah, of course go compliantly. And then I'm going to wink over at Dolma.
Don't drag me into your crap.
Let the others know where I am.
They lead you back down into the storage. Into a set of iron cages down there. They look at the cages. They look at you. And they're like looking at the size of the little bars on the cages and then your size. And they decide to chain you up instead. They put a restraint around one of your ankles.
Good old fashioned shackle.
Yep.
All right.
Are there any insects down here?
There probably are, but you don't see any in your immediate vicinity.
Okay. Well, when I find one, I would like to cast Animal Friendship on it.
Okay. The two there are arguing which one of them needs to search you. All right, so the others of y'all have seen Alexander being hauled away. And are hearing commotion that they may have caught the person that blew a hole in the side of the ship.
All right, so I'll gather up with the others and we need to talk to somebody about this. He's a dumbass, but he didn't blow the hole in the side of the ship. And especially not with that stupid wand.
Yeah. I use my chant to grab that and bring it to me.
I would think the guards would have picked
it up. You don't have access to the wand.
Is there a guard in the door right now?
Yes.
Do they have keys for the door?
Give me a perception roll. See if you see any keys around them.
Oh my god.
That's a four.
You don't see any keys.
In my personal opinion, we need to try to do this above board because we don't need to be trying to do a jailbreak a day out from port.
See, my personal opinion. Thing I was worried about, though, was us getting put in shift.
I'm down for to go.
I do not have the greatest charisma score for this, but we need to talk to who's in charge.
Well, I have the charisma score, and so does our paladin over there.
Yeah, I just...
None of this should use deception. I mean, we're not lying. The wand definitely did not cause the boons.
Yeah. You're going to need more persuasion than anything else.
Both he and I have a plus +5 to that, so.
Yep. Feel free. Because I have a -1.
And it might be best if two of us go for this, so, you know. Two of us trying to convince and not just one.
Maybe play up the he's not the brightest angle.
I mean,
he's not.
It's not a lie.
No. I'm worried he's going to say something in there.
I'm going to get close enough so he's within 120 feet and tell him our plans so he can shut the fuck up.
So, have I seen a bug yet?
Give me a perception roll. Nineteen. You do see a bug.
Alright. So I'm gonna cast Animal Friendship on it.
Okay.
And then it's gonna, you know, I'm gonna call it over. And then I'm gonna start singing. Nobody knows the trouble I've seen. Nobody knows.
Even the bug goes away.
Anybody have a lockjaw spell?
Silent?
Silent. Silence.
I've been floating on an airship. I did not explode.
Okay.
Here now. Oh. And they hurt my toe. Someone else is setting fires. Someone's upsetting and destroying.
Okay, you called over this bug and you are now singing to it.
Yep.
Alright. So the others of you. So Angel and
Mordrum,
sorry, my nose is killing me. While striking Mordrum, y'all are planning on talking to somebody?
Yeah.
We got it.
Who are you talking to?
You know, that's actually a good question.
Who are you going to go make your case to?
Can we track down the people that arrested him? And, or something, I don't know. Or even whoever we can find that would probably be some sort of leader.
Who's the highest ranking?
The captain.
Yeah, but he's probably busy flying the ship.
Well, no, I mean, like, in the rig.
Oh, in the hold where you are at?
Yeah.
You're not sure these guys are all fairly... There's no insignia difference between their uniforms.
Oh. Just letting you know, I'm also going to cast Distort Value on my ankle shackle to make it look really fancy.
Okay.
Wow, he's bored in there.
Bored in the house. In the house bored.
Shh.
All right. Go up.
No, I was. So who are y'all going to see?
Sounded like he was trying to say something, so I was waiting.
Oh, yeah, no, I was going to approach one of the guards there. Who do we talk to about the release of our friend there?
Oh, you need to go talk to Thrist. Maybe the captain.
Yeah. Don't get me but wrong.
Right now, things aren't looking too good. You know, the hole in the ship.
He's harmless.
The fireworks and the thing. You know.
Like I said, he's a moron. I'll get this straightened out. We'll get taken care of for you guys.
Shh. All right.
So now we know who to go to.
Yeah.
So y'all are headed to Thrist or the captain?
Well, Thrist is the one that holding the item, one guy, right? Or the book.
Yes.
Yeah, okay. What do you think about going to talk to him?
Yeah, we can probably talk to him first and then move on. Maybe we can gain some ground with him.
All right, well, y'all are going to Thrist. What are the other two of y'all doing? Doma and Ragnark.
I'll talk to Ragnark and be like, man, we need to like stay back from this for a minute just in case other activity becomes necessary, but let's let them do their thing and just kind of be unobtrusive.
I agree with Doma.
All right. Alexander, go ahead.
I was going to say, because if they decide to say, oh, so your accomplices, and throw them in jail, then we may have to resort to other measures.
Yep.
All right, Alexander, what are you singing to your bug now?
Probably happy birthday, because I don't know when it was born. Well, it probably won't have much longer to live.
All right, what are you singing after that?
Bad to the bone.
And with that, because I'm not going to leave on anybody singing happy birthday because there's been too much litigation around that song. you start singing bad to the bone. Bad. As we're going to end there this week. Because it is almost midnight here. And we'll pick this back up next week. At the Obsidian Curtain. I am tired. Y'all have a good night. And until next time, go forth and roll some dice.
Good night.
Night, everybody.
Good night.